I completed my doctoral degree work trying to find out what was going on in the relationship between children's cognitive ability and their language ability. And that has extended into trying to understand why some children struggle so much to acquire language when they seem to have all of the necessary prerequisites to do that. In effect, they don't seem to be that much different from other children, but yet they are incredibly different from younger children. And this has informed a whole series of R01 awards from the National Institute of Health. And as we have moved forward over time, it has become a longitudinal study, because as we learn more about what was happening with the children, we really wanted to understand genetic differences and if that could be creating some of the causal pathways. And once we were doing the genetic work, we became committed to family-based genetic studies. The upshot of all of this is a very long-term program of investigation. And the thrust of it has been to understand how children grow over time in their language ability, and whether or not those who struggle to acquire language on time are likely to have other members of the family with a similar problem. We now have been at it for so long, we're doing it for more than 20 years now. We have some children of the children. We have people that we're continuing to follow as they age, and for some of those people, we knew what they were like when they were 4 years of age. They're now in their early 20s, and we have their four-year-old and five-year-old children who are also with us. Not only do children with specific language impairment start late, and they continue to show language delays relative to their age periods for a long period of time. That has been very exciting to be able to document that longitudinally. At the same time, the really exciting part is they're very good at making change over time. So the work has led to a distinction between when they start and then what happens as they change over time. And the change over time is quite similar to the way children who have good language change over time. The difference is that they start later, so they're not likely to catch up. And if they're not likely to catch up, the other piece of the news story is that there seems to be an amount of time that's available for them to continue to do the changing. And somewhere in pre-adolescence, somewhere around 10, 12-ish, if they don't have it all worked out by then it begins to level off. So we're thinking of this now more in terms of both incredible strengths as well as some very serious kind of weaknesses. And the weaknesses in the language acquisition system persists into adulthood as well. It looks like in the next 5 years, we're going to be able to focus very closely on these mechanisms of change over time. And if our program of work continues to hit our marks, we'll be able to look into which genes control other genes and what the timing is for those. If I were to have all of my wishes answered, we would understand why some children don't begin to talk and use language on time when they're young. In that period of 2 years or so, when most children are beginning to use words in simple sentences. And then we will be able to understand the other part of the problem we have to get at is how is it that they're able to do so well once they're started? What controls that? And then what is causing the system to be less effective at learning language in that middle childhood, pre-adolescent period. So if we all live long enough, we might get a little bit closer to this.